Some time ago, I made a sort of travel guide to the places I wanted to go if I visited Korea. I still have some of them on mind, but as I'm growing and everything around me changes, my preferences change too. So today I wanted to make a kind of update or complimentary video about the places I'd like to visit in Korea. I have no plans of traveling to Korea soon, unless I win the K-Influencer Award. So I'd rather take this more as a list of options rather than a guide. Last video I was going crazy about Busan, but lately Jeju has been more present for me. Not necessarily the adult X zone, but the area where our blues was filmed. It looks like a perfect getaway to relax and get in touch with nature, all while still being close to society. As I have mentioned before, I grew up in a coastal city, but I was never close enough to the beach to visit it at my will. Trips there happen only on holidays, so I cannot say I enjoyed it as much as I wish. I sometimes see videos of people who live closer to the beaches, and I feel so envious of them, because I would honestly love to end my days listening to the sound of waves, at least for a period of time. So with that in mind, here are three places in Jeju that I'd love to visit, the influencer staff. Number 1, Geumnung Beach. According to Visit Korea, it is a less crowded tourist destination, which makes it the perfect spot to take a nap on the sand or just to reset while listening to the sound of the waves. Number 2, Citrus Gardening Cafe. I've seen some reviews of this place on TikTok, and I think it will be a great option to end the day. I'm honestly a little bit scared of staying at the beach at night, so I would gladly go there before the sun fully sets to enjoy some pastries and some smoothies. Number 3, Sincheon Windmill Coastal Road. And lastly, this will be my preferred place to take pictures and act like a tourist. It has many places designed to give tourists a good experience, so I think a vlog here will come out amazing. Those are my three current top places to visit in 2024-2025, if I get the chance. I still want to eat street food in Seoul, and maybe go to K-pop pop-up stores or fine events. I'd also love to visit some stores focused on polka decoration and stationery. But I feel like I may want to rest first to fully enjoy all these experiences in the city. That's why my top 3 places are more focused on relaxing. I guess that's what people mean when they say that you'll know when you're getting old. But anyway, have you heard about them? Would you like to visit them too? Let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. See you later.